Hi, Chris from Dynojet here. In this video, I'm going to discuss some of the quick tune items in your Dynojet Power Vision screen for Harley Davidsons. We're going to go over the various items, what they are, and how you can change them. Now, to access quick tune from the main menu, we'll select Program Vehicle, and we'll hit Quick Tune. Our first tab, under General, we can change the idle RPM. We can add and subtract to our current idle speed. We can change the rev limiter of the vehicle, higher and lower. And we can choose to reset the adaptive fuel trims that were learned. Here under the Configure tab, we have a toggle to turn off ACR, which is our automatic compression release. We can also toggle on and off whether or not the bike has heated stock O2 sensors. Over here, we have toggles for active intake and active exhaust. These are found on Harley-Davidson models sold outside of the United States. Down here at the bottom, we have our calibration for our vehicle speed sensor. Under the Tweaks tab, we have a switch to turn off adaptive control, which is the ECM's capability to learn. We also have a switch to turn off knock control. This is the ECM's capability to retard ignition timing when a pinging event is detected. We can turn on and off closed loop, which is the capability to regulate fuel through the O2 sensors. We also have an EATMIS toggle. This is an engine idle temperature management system. This regulates engine temperature while idling. Under the fuel tab, we have the capability to make adjustments to our air fuel ratio, our lambda table, in our tune. We have adjustments for low, mid, or high RPM. We have an adjustment for global, which affects all RPMs. We have a deceleration range adjustment, and we have a high lugging adjustment. We have the same six adjustments which modify the spark tables of our tune. And under the VE tab, we have the same six adjustments that alter the volumetric efficiency tables of our tune. If we hit the defaults button, it will reset all parameters and all tabs to the factory defaults. Once we're finished making our edits, we can hit save, and it'll prompt us to flash this into the ECM. We'll hit yes. It'll flash the ECM. And then the screen will prompt us to turn the key off for 10 seconds. And now that you know how to utilize the Quick Tune feature, you can make a simple edit to your current tune without ever touching the computer software.